I have to educate myself. And you're not the man to help me with that. I have to do it by myself. That's why I'm leaving you.
What did you say?
I have to stand on my own two feet if I'm ever to know myself and the things that are going on around me. That's why I can't stay in your house any longer.
Nora.
Leaving right away.
Are you mad? You'll do no such thing. I forbid you to.
It's no use your forbidding me anything now. I shall take what belongs to me. I don't want anything from you now or ever.
This is madness.
To go back home tomorrow. I mean, back to my old home. It'll be easy for me to find something to do there.
You can't abandon your home, your husband, and your children. Have you thought what people will say?
I can't go worrying about that. All I know is it's something I have to do.
This is outrageous. It's going back on your most sacred duty.
And what, in your opinion, are my most sacred duties?
Well, surely you don't have to ask me that. I mean, your duties to your husband and your children.
I have other duties which are just as sacred.
No, you haven't. What, for example?
My duties to myself.
Before anything else, you're a mother and a wife.
I don't believe that anymore. I believe that before anything else, I am a human being, just as much of one as you are. Or at least that I must try to make myself into one. Oh, I know most people would agree with you, Torvald, and you'd be backed up by all sorts of books, but well, what most people say and what you find in books just doesn't satisfy me anymore. I want to find things out for myself and make my own decisions.
You don't seem to understand your position in your own house. There's an infallible guide in this sort of situation, you know. It's your religion. What about that?
Torvald, I don't really know what religion is. I only know what Pastor Hansen told me when I was confirmed. He told me religion was this and religion was that. And I've got out of all this and I'm on my own. I'll be able to think that over as well. I want to find out whether the things Pastor Hansen told me are true, or at any rate, whether they're true for me.
But that sort of thing is unheard of in a young woman. Well, if you refuse to be guided by your religion, at least let me appeal to your conscience. I suppose you have some sort of a moral code, or perhaps you don't.
It's not an easy question to answer. I don't really know. I find it all quite bewildering. The only thing I do know is that my opinions about these things are quite different from yours. I've also found out that the law is different from what I thought, but what I cannot accept is that the law is right. That a woman isn't allowed to spare a dying father or save her husband's life. I won't accept that.
Don't be so childish. You don't seem to understand the first thing about the society you're living in.
No, I don't. That's why I want to make myself part of it. I want to find out which of us is right, society or me.
Nora, I think you must be ill, feverish. You seem to have lost your senses.
I have never felt as convinced and as lucid as I do tonight.
You're convinced and lucid, and yet you're abandoning your husband and children.
Yes, that's right.